What? Tonight's gonna be in the 50s?
Why is it so cold?
Woo! What is up, all you real people? Welcome back. Well, guys, I did go fishing last week. I know it's been a while since I uploaded, but I did go fishing last week, and it was not the best. It was a little slow. Fishing was a little slow, especially after all the rain we had. It was a little slow. I was expecting a lot more bites, especially a lot more topwater. Shut up, Cat. No one asked you. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, so the bite was a little slow on the fishing, but I did get some video, and then I had to spend some time with my girlfriend because, you know, we have not spent time together in a while. She's a full-time college student. Me, I work nights, I go fishing during the day, I do all my stuff, so we just really need to have some time together. So me and her went to the zoo, went out to Olive Garden, had a really good time, but I do have some video clips to show y'all from last week. Let me sit you on the tripod. But yeah, I do have some video to show y'all from last week, the fishing, and if y'all want the zoo, y'all can watch that if you want. If you don't, thank you for your time. But yeah, I don't know if y'all saw in the beginning of this video, it is starting to get cold here in Texas. I am really surprised. Last night I was at work, I walked outside to go on my lunch break, and I was like, wow, holy crap, I think it was down to like 55. It was awesome. I love the cool weather. I'm a huge fan of it. Summers here in Texas, they suck because it gets so hot and the mosquitoes bite you and you feel like you're dying from the outside. But yes, fall is finally here. Thank you, God. I love fall. It gets nice, cool, crisp, coffee, soup weather, hot cocoa. Perfect. I love it. I even love fishing in it. To me, I don't know why, I feel like the fish bite more with me during the colder years. So, awesome, awesome, awesome. But anyway, guys, let's get in these video clips I have for y'all today. I love y'all. Make sure, if you haven't already, please make sure to like and subscribe to the Darkreel Action channel. Hit the big thumbs up if you like the video. Hit the notification bell for awesome videos like this. I love you guys. Let's get into it. That would be the first bass of the day on the old Carolina rig with the trench hog. Not bad, not bad. All right, little buddy. Go tell your friends about us. Seth got a double on the cranks. Dadgum. Get my pliers. Oh well, those are mine.
This fish is laying on the bottom. When I caught him, got mud on my hands. That's not shit, it's mud.
I think this one is, I think my crankbait goes like right over the top of the bottom. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it feels good to have that slime on my hands.
Did it just stop it in its tracks?
Now you pushed it.
Ooh.
Big ones will grab it, and it's coming back towards you like this.
Uh-huh.
They'll hit it, and they'll go this way with it.
Oh, it knocks slack in it.
You just end up with 6 foot of slack in your line.
Oh. Got him. That's a nice one. I think. I don't know. He's way down there. He's coming. Where are you at, buddy? Oh, yeah. It's about a pound and a half. Come here. Love it. Ain't nothing like those crankbait bites. Oh yeah. There we go, baby. Yeah, on the mud. Mud all on this bottom. I love it. Daddy wants a big one. Is it getting on that little?
Yeah. When you tied your polymer knot, you didn't tie it down all the way or something? Or you tied just a funky ass knot? Okay, I see what you did there. Okay.
Probably just tied a funky ass knot.
Yeah. You just didn't cinch that bitch down or something. I don't know what the fuck you did there.
Yeah, me neither.
Okay.
Need some slack.
Tie a polymer knot?
I think so, but show me anywhere.
Okay. Go through this, the front. That's the front of the hook right there,
mm-hmm.
Right? Pull you out a big old loop on the drop shot only. On the regular bait, you don't have to do that. So you got a loop and two tag ends. With me?
Mm-hmm.
Drop your rod tip for me. Yeah. Overhand knot. With me.
Uh-huh.
Keep your finger in the loop so it doesn't close down all the way. Bait through the loop. Alright. Pull that sucker tight. Think you remember that?
Uh-huh.
It's the strongest fishing knot there is. The rod's broken, by the way. You notice that.
Oh yeah, I know.
Okay. And see. see how that has two lines going between the hook and the knot?
Mm-hmm.
That's what makes it so strong. And you take your tag in and go back through the front of the hook, okay? Just like that. So now your shit is standing up straight up and down every time.
Gotcha.
And see how it's not, you gotta watch out if this knot will spin around and get caught in that groove right there. Mm-hmm. So you wanna make sure it's not doing that, because that'll catch your line when you hook a big one. So that's ever pulled down. And then you can just tie whatever knot right here. I usually just do a couple overhand knots, but on this one you can do a barrel knot so it stays on that sucker. Swivel. Do a quick little barrel knot to keep that on there. And then hook your bait on here. What I like to do is line my hook up like this and see kind of where it's at right there.
Uh-huh.
And line it up even with it. And come through this bitch. Skin hook it back down like this. That does a couple things. Number one, keeps your bait straight like that. It's not sitting there flopping around doing whatever.
Okay.
Right. Number two, it's weedless.
Right.
Ooh. Now let's try to find it. I do not see it.
Not unless you want the coronas.
Oh, I see him.
Oh, he's hiding behind that log.
Yeah, there he is. He's hiding behind that leaf.
Hello, Boyd.
Have you seen Kung Fu Panda lately?
Oh, he didn't like that. He's like, don't bring up bad memories. Yeah, just keep on walking.